Nighttime operations been launched by the police in New York to evict the Occupy Wall Street protesters from their camp in the city's financial district. Hundreds of officers moved onto the site in Zuccotti Park at around 1 o'clock in the morning local time. Well, police said protesters could return once the camp had been cleaned. It's reported some people have been arrested. Protesters have been demonstrating for 2 months against the banking system.
They didn't want to go. No surrender, they shout, as some tie themselves to posts to stop them being dragged away.
It's gonna be all right.
2 months of protest and a threat to actually shut down the stock exchange on Thursday, and the New York police moved in. They barricaded the streets. They lit up the area with spotlights and began clearing the tents and people from Zuccotti Park.
My phone is in the hole!
They were given only 20 minutes notice. News also came in a Twitter message from the city mayor, Michael Bloomberg. They should temporarily leave the park.
I guarantee it, you will remember this moment for the rest of your beautiful, God-given lives!
Dozens were arrested amid allegations of property being destroyed and people being roughed up.
They're taking the park, they're surrounding the park in riot gear. They're taking it and they're trying to block up every street right now. They're lining up to surround us. I don't know, anywhere but here, I can't get arrested tonight.
A day ago, Oakland in California was cleared in a similar way. This is now the strength of government pitted against anger about an unfair financial system.
This is something that's a significant force in society that demands to be listened to, and it probably won't go away until it is listened to.
Technically, these Manhattan scenes are of a city park being prepared for cleaning. Everyone knows it's far more. The disruption of a global financial center, thousands of police sent to protect it as the seeds of discontent grow about the gap between the rich and the poor. Humphrey Hawksley, BBC News.
Well, this is a scene live in New York at the moment. You can see the street cleaners are out in force and the camp has been totally cleared. We understand some protesters clearly wanting to continue their campaign. Not clear whether they will return to this particular area or move on to somewhere where they can actually camp again. Well, earlier, our correspondent Laura Trevelyan explained that the evicted protesters feel that the latest move by the New York Police Department is an infringement of their own right of assembly.
It's a very confused scene. This is the closest that I can get to the park, about a block away. Police in riot gear are lining the streets around it. They're not allowing any access, so I can't see for myself what's going on. But I've been talking to protesters who have been leaving the park. They've been telling me the police used batons to clear them out, that the police threw their stuff into garbage trucks, into rubbish trucks, and told them they could come and get it back in the morning when the park has been cleared. I just spoke to a mother who was concerned because her two sons were inside the park. So right now it's an unclear picture. But what is for sure is that the protesters feel that they have been evicted. They say this is an infringement of their right to free speech and freedom of assembly. But the police told them that the conditions in the park were just insanitary and unhygienic, and they had to go while it was being cleaned. Protesters say they intend to retake the park in the morning, but they're not allowed to have sleeping bags or tents or tarpaulins there anymore. So it does look like this is the end of the encampment. At least there, the protesters are trying to regroup, maybe elsewhere in the city, or maybe they really will try to go back in and reoccupy that park.
But the police have said that they are allowed to go back in as long as they're just not pitching camps. And has there been any real evidence of police mistreatment of the protesters, or is this just something that we're hearing word of mouth from the demonstrators themselves?
Well, I talked to two protesters who were inside the encampment at 1 a.m. when the police came in, one of whom just left of her own accord, but the other, a man, told me that the police used a baton on him because he wouldn't leave. Another protester that I talked to, who wasn't in the encampment but who came down as soon as he heard that there was an eviction, he told me, and he was gathering with many others on the side of the park, he told me the police used tear gas to disperse them. Now, right now, the mood is tense, but I haven't seen any violence. I've seen a lot of angry scuffles between the police and the protesters. Protesters angry about what's happened. The protesters filming the police, taking down their identification numbers. But as you can see, this is just the closest that we can get to the actual park itself.
Laura Trevelyan there in New York.